Okay, it's Wednesday, July 19th, 2017. My back thermometer, the digital one, says 86 degrees. It's closer, I think, 92, 93 degrees out here. It's going to be a real hot one today. And at 7 o'clock, I'm going to do like we did a couple years ago, which really, really helped a lot, too. I got a little round sprinkler, which we're going to put out there for the hummingbirds around 5 o'clock so they can get some relief from the heat. They fly into it, so really cool. But I'm gonna put it out in the garden, starting in number 3 in the back for 20 minutes, so it'll give a good soaking. And then number 2 garden, 20 minutes. Then number 3 and the west end over here, and then number 1 garden. So, you know, by 8:30, about 9 o'clock, it should be all done. But it's hot out here, folks. Make no mistake, it's really hot. I just want to get a picture of this this Frigidaire 15,100 BTU unit that's in our living room window, which is actually, that is freezing that house out, which is cool with me. Usually we had one in the kitchen there and an older one that went out on us while we had visitors here from out of state, and then we got that one, and that thing will freeze you out, which is cool. This is it right here. It's a Frigidaire. The one we have in our kitchen was one we had about four or five years is a Frigidaire also. Good air conditioner. I'm telling you, it'll keep that. It says 850 square feet. The living room is maybe about 400 square feet approximately. So you know it's cooling off the rest of the house too. I'm going to take a picture of this after I do this video, which primarily I came out here to just show you the heat out here in the garden. I figured I'd get this on this video, whatever you want to call it, this recording. So it's a really nice system. Mr. Dumas Thomas, thank you very much, sir. It's got a 2-year warranty on it. And like I say, it's making that, it's keeping that house cool. So anyway, back to the garden. You can see I have a brown spot all over the tomatoes. I've been peeling off the leaves and all that, but we got green. I mean, there's a lot of green coming back because you gotta get all the contamination off of the brown spot on the tomatoes. And quite a few tomatoes, man, already. We've picked off 9 or 10, had one already. I want some fried green tomatoes yet before they start turning red. I'm gonna get some more of those larger tomatoes, because most of these are all the big 1 pound plus size tomatoes that we have out here. We got 7 of them out here, of which 4 are doing really, really, really good. And the other 3 are doing okay. They're not bad, but they're doing okay just. And then the garlic we're going to probably end up taking up this weekend. It's so hot right now. It's going to be hot all week. It's going to get up to 99 by Friday. So the broccoli over there might die from all this heat, because that should be out in February and be all done by May. So we put it out late. We got cucumber over there, which will go. But usually it's on, you know, plastic or grass, but it's all bare over there. So those things are getting really dried out. There's 5 cucumber plants over there getting dried out. Watermelon and cantaloupe in the back. Beans and peas over here on the west end of the number 3 garden. There's little CJ and Lucy, the further one back. My sunflowers are coming up pretty good. We got these here that were just 8. Now there's about 10, 11, 12. They got all the different various heads on some of them. Those are attracting butterflies now. We're starting to get butterflies around here. Oh, it's hot out here. So, I call it a sunflower fence is what I called it, because I wanted to have it like this all the way around the garden. There's 2 torch right here, and then there's a regular yellow head sunflower torch and a yellow one right there, and then yellow. And you see the orange one is a torch sunflower, wherever you see the orange flowers. But it was supposed to be, let me zoom back out. It was supposed to be like this, all the way to the corner, all the way down the north end, and all the way up the east end over there. And they're sporadic, but whoa, it's hot out here. By August, I'll be out and do another, I know I'll do at least a few more videos before August is here. But, and those I had planted down there when I put the garlic down with Tracy. We had 27 garlics down there, and like they look like they're drying out already. That's really a bad spot because we didn't grass it really good, degrass it, whatever. So this next fall, we're gonna really, really, really till the crap out of it right there. And we might do the whole thing. We might put we're gonna put more garlic cloves down there, so we should have around 40 or more bulbs of garlic for next July. We'll do that around October, November, somewhere in that area. And then by July, it should be ready to come up. Like now, it's ready. But, oh man, it's hot out here, I have to tell you. I can't go on about that. I mean, I got sweat rolling down my leg, the middle of my back, down the crack of my butt. And I'm dripping with sweat right now. Yeah, and I'm standing here in the shade. So that's how hot it is out here. I'd say it's probably about 92 degrees, 93 degrees. It's, I'd say around, oh wait, I think I have my, what they call it, no, I don't. I had a cell phone which has a clock on it. And I was going to say it at the time, but I must have put it in the house when I came in. So, there's our little rosemary bush right there. Hoping that gets much bigger, and Tracy can maybe transplant. Have like four or five of them around the garden. We got basil. There's a purple. I'm gonna might as well get out in the sun. I hate going out in the sun, but anyway, here I go for you guys. Oh boy, let me get up here. Ooh, it's hot. It's hot, folks. Like I said, this will go into October, easy. So we can plant more tomatoes out here, more tomato plants. But let me get around there. See, that's basil. What's that one? I thought I saw. There's basil. Basil. It's a tomato plant, which had a lot of brown spot. As you can see, all the bareness. We had a couple worms out here. We got some worms off. But a lot of this is from the brown spot where I had to break off. If you break it off, example, if this has got brown spot on it, and this is a good leaf, you break it off just past that good leaf. So you go back and you get all the disease off as much as you keep up on it. But I was sick for almost 10 days, man. And that really sucked. I had company here from Ohio. And all I did was lay in bed, perhaps sit around in the house. I mean, I'm telling you what, it sucked, period. Enough about me, right? Anyway, this basil, these thick tomato sticks, we got situated here for at least one, two, three more tomatoes right now. We were gonna have four. Oh man, I can't think right here because of the heat. One, two, three. I thought I had it set for four. I think I was gonna go right down where that square little opening is right there. It's kind of close to this one and that one. I don't know. We'll see. So at least right now we got three, and then by the house we're gonna put down one or two at least. But I was going over here to show you the basil. See, now that's a purple basil one, and I'm sorry. I apologize. Heirloom solutions or solutions from science or however. They want to be called by. We got some free seeds from one of the guys because, you know, we had some challenges with other stuff. And we ordered some basil, and I ordered another pack of basil, and he sent me a pack of that purple basil. I'm telling you what, we had two of them out here, but with the winds that are out here, you see this torch sunflower right here? Okay, that's almost on a 75 degree angle. I got stakes in there and everything else tied to it because otherwise it would be laid over onto this ground right here. Look at that big giant mammoth sunflower. See how it's on an angle? I got a crappy little tomato stake in there with it tied because when it was smaller, it was leaning over more. And that's about 9 feet tall. But, we got ladyfinger eggplants right there. Man, those, I mean, with the butterflies out here and the bees, they're long eggplants. It's an heirloom type. I can't wait to try those. I thought I planted both, which I may have, but, you know, with the winds out here, knocking stuff over. I mean, knocking it over, but like if you've seen any of my other videos, we had sunflowers like that, those mammoth ones, where those are all sitting right there, and it knocked them over, knocked them totally over. So, the wind out here gets pretty nasty, and I say that all the time. Most people might chuckle about it, but, yeah, you go through it first. But that's an eggplant, ladyfinger eggplant, which is pretty cool. And where the flowers are, where the eggplants will come out. The actual vegetable fruit, whatever you want to call it. But I wanted to show that purple basil right there. That's about 18 inches, maybe almost 20 inches tall. That's 20 inches tall. That one's about 18 inches tall. I'd say 18. That one there is a bunch of basil right there. That's where my wife was separating them. There's a bunch in there. There's about five or six at least in there. But that's when she separated them out here to kind of keep the insects away, which helped a lot. Next year, I'm going to try doing that right by the tomato plant. I have one by each tomato plant. Like, you see that little piece of wood down there? You'd have a basil like that size right next to the tomato plant. And that'll detract all the worms and a lot of the other insects. So there you go.